Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about public goods. As we know, in the subject public finance, we can classify goods into main three categories: public goods, private goods and merit goods. Here we will discuss about public goods. What is public goods? Paul S. Emulsen, who is a well-known economist who expressed the modern theory of public goods, in his classic paper The Pure Theory of Public Expenditure, he defined a public good, or as he called it in the paper, a collective consumption good, as follows. According to him, public good means which all enjoy in common, in the sense that each individual's consumption of such a good leads to no subtraction from any other individual's consumption of that goods. J. Sloman said, a good or service is which has the features of non-rivalry and non-excludability, and as a result would not be provided by the market. Let's discuss the features of public goods. How we can identify public goods? The first feature is public goods are indivisible. It means we can't divide public goods or the services of public goods. For example, army, service of army or a defense facilities, we can't divide it. We can't say a one citizen of a country is getting this much of benefit of service of army, and we can't say another person or another citizen is getting benefit of this much from the army service. We can't divide it. Public goods are indivisible. We can't divide it. Second one is non-excludability. It means we can't exclude, we can't stop anyone from the using public goods. Like, we can't stop anyone to enter in the public park. Okay, or if in the radio broadcast, people who are present at there, they enjoy, or we can't exclude anyone to hearing that broadcast. Non-rivalry means a consumption of one individual is not reduce the consumption of other. In a function, point. Recite the poem. So consumption of one individual can't reduce the consumption of other. Or in a classroom, when a teacher take a lecture, during the lecture all the students take the same benefit from that lecture. Consumption of one student is not reduce the consumption of other students. This one is the example of non-rivalry. In short, non-rivalry means consumption of one individual is not reduce the consumption of other. Okay. Compulsory contribution by the member of society is required for public goods. Generally, public goods are provided or produced by the government, and for that government required income, and government earn income by imposing taxes. So compulsory contribution by a member of society is required for public goods. Public goods production and facing can't be left to market mechanism. So public goods are produced and financed by government. Why market is not interested in that type of good? Because public goods are have a characteristics of non-excludability and a non-rivalry, and as a result market is not interested to produce or finance that type of commodity. Market is interested investing in those commodities which are profitable, and in the case of public goods it's not possible. Producer can also close the production when they faces the loss, but in the case of public goods, government can't prevent or stop the production because they all are the part of welfare goods. Or for the welfare of society, government can't prevent or stop the production of public goods. What are the limitation of public goods? Public goods are non-rival and non-excludable. This assumption is not true. In a certain cases, public goods are not non-excludable. We can exclude someone from the consumption of public goods. And same way, consumption of one person or individual reduce the consumption of other. In certain cases, public goods are non-rival and non-excludable. This assumption is not true. It is difficult to measure the benefit of defense, and it is also difficult to draw the difference between the public goods and private goods. Thank you very much.